There's 8 games today, so there's one early game kicking off in 15 minutes, QPR Norwich. Then 6 games at 3 o'clock, and then one late game at 5:30. So yeah, it'll get busy around 3 o'clock. We are the content and customer service team, so we will provide all the stats for our Twitter feeds, for our clients. Editorially, we'll be doing features, packs for TV companies, sending everything out to the newspapers. Whereas the guys in the other room in the operations team, they'll be recording all the data, and they will be sort of handling everything that goes on behind the scenes. We can't plan what's going to happen. We know, sort of, we have a set routine of things we need to do. We have a list of everything we need to do. But, I mean, football's unpredictable. You can never tell what's going to happen. So this is our analysis room. At the moment they're analysing the game live. We have a guy for each team and a checker, so if anyone has any sort of questions about the data they're putting in, they'll flag it up and then the checker can check by just going back, replaying the footage and then re-inputting the data. On certain games we record about 1,800 actions a game, so I mean around 900 a team. Obviously it's going to be a lot more if you're analysing Barcelona than you are Stoke or QPR or Norwich. We have about 200 applications every summer for operations guys. Maybe 4 or 5 will get through to the final section where they'll be trained up. I mean, hand-eye coordination has to be amazing. I couldn't do this myself, I'm too slow. But these guys, I mean, a few of them have been here for a few years, so they've built up a great skill set to be able to do this.
I definitely could not do it. I know that for the hand-eye coordination they have. So it's a pretty intense, you know, you've got to be doing it, it's live, you've got 45 minutes late. You know, they've got a little bit of time to go back and check errors during the breaks, and we obviously go through every match after it's happened, but while they're doing it, it's pretty intense, 45, 50 minutes at a time where you don't have much let up, and it's a pretty impressive demonstration of skills. I'm not sure what skills and how they've built them up, but it's more than I can do, certainly.
It takes a unique kind of person. I mean, if you're good at computer games, it helps. And if you have to have a really, really good knowledge of football as well. So the speed at which everything happens, you have to be able to tell which player's which at the sort of blink of an eye. So if someone's wearing yellow boots, you might be able to say that means that's that player. And sometimes, I mean, Man United have Raphael and Fabio, two twins in the team. So you've got to know the characteristics of each player as well, and despite they're both playing on different wings, if something was to come into the box, you might need sort of to know if one wears white boots, one has tape around his socks or something like that, so yeah, you can pick that up. A lot of it's communication. If one of them has a question, he might say, can you double check? So a defender may have made a clearance, but it might have been a long ball instead, so they'd ask the checker to just check that, replay it, and then if it needs correcting, correct it straight away. So here, we can replay the data, and they can double check and pause and see. So quite often, if there's a deflection on a goal and we're not sure if it's an own goal, we can then slow it down, replay it, pause it, so we can take different angles and have a look at whether it is an own goal or not. Luckily, the early game today is a dull affair between QPR and Norwich. I say that now, and when you film again at 90 minutes, it'll be 4-all. But yeah, I mean, there's not much going on at the moment until something big happens, maybe a goal, red card, a penalty. We're liaising with commentators for the game across the world, providing them with facts and data. So yeah, just waiting for something big to happen, and then we can get down and do our job.
How common is it that you will pull together some fact or amazing piece of trivia, send it off from your computer, and then you hear it come across on the TV a minute or two later?
Yeah, quite often. I mean, there was a famous one in the World Cup a few years ago when Rob Green disastrously let Clint Dempsey shot for his hands against the USA. And straight away, our team were on to it, and we remembered that he'd actually made the most mistakes leading to goals in the Premier League that season as well. Oh, it was on ITV, mentioned it. We were being told on Opta Joe that across the world commentators were mentioning our fact that it was on Opta Joe. So that was a really nice moment for us. And then, yeah, you quite often, I think Mark's doing the commentator support at the moment, you'll hear something that he's just put across to them within 30 seconds. So that's as quick as it can happen. So if now there's a red card, we could research a fact about that red card, say it might be the player's 8th red card, only 2 players have got more, or they're the team with the most red cards this season. We can put that straight to the commentator, and then they can have that out and mention it on screen within a minute. So, I mean, while the action's fresh and while the stat is fresh, they'll have it out there. So
the commentator sounds so knowledgeable when they do that. Does that frustrate you and make you think you didn't know that? That was because of me, or is
In fairness, the commentators do a lot of research before the game. We're helping them out. That's our job. QPR just won a penalty. Norwich are giving it away, so I can have a quick look now to see sort of how many penalties have been given this season for each side using our database. Right, so we can have a quick look now to see Norwich's record this season using running a report. This season, QPR have won two penalties, both of them have been against Norwich, home and away, and they've had both of them saved.
QPR have now had the last three penalties in a row saved, so I'll put that straight through now to this guy's board. Come on, dude.
The decision to retain a player or sign a player is, I mean, it's literally a multi-million pound or euro or dollar or whatever. It's a multi-million something investment. I can't imagine many other walks of life, many other businesses where you would just take that based upon kind of someone's feel and intuition, and you'd have someone sitting there watching them do their job. It doesn't make sense. You'd normally have numbers, some way of quantifying that.
The game's ended a poor draw. Not the best for our analysis. There's not too much to talk about, so we're trying to put together some post-match facts now. QPR are now 5 unbeaten in the Premier League, which is their best run in the Premier League since March 95. A nice little one about Harry Redknapp, that he's drawn more games 0-0 than any other manager in the Premier League. 62nd, that was. What we do now is we just put together the post-match facts, save all the stats for the game, send them out to the media, and then sort of just wait for the 3 o'clock games and the fun to start. I'd say it's been an above average day for action. There's quite a lot going on, as there's 6 games at the moment. Lucas Podolski's just scored for Arsenal, so, but it seems to have been disallowed. But yeah, I mean, it's been pretty hectic. I mean, there's a flurry of goals around the midway point of the first half. So yeah, it's been all right. There's plenty of stuff sort of coming out today. So yeah, it's good.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah.